Sujiva Goswami says, by hearing Bhakti Shastra, devotional literatures continuously, Shraddha or faith awakens. That Shraddha is characterized by unflinching faith, that one understands my only duty is the performance of Bhagavad Bhajan. But to perform bhajan, I need a spiritual master. After taking shelter of the Guru, one will perform Vishwamena Guru Seva. One will serve the Guru full of intimacy, and from him learn the process of bhajan. The relationship with the Guru will become like Lokik Satbandhuba, means very close, like almost like a materialistic friendship, means so close, so near and dear. This Guru Seva is the doorway by which to enter the kingdom of bhakti. Therefore, Bhagavan has also said that, Videha Madhyam Sulabham, Labham Sukalpam, Guru Kanadaram. The spiritual master is like a captain to take the boat of the human body across the ocean of birth and death. Therefore, Srimad Bhagavatam has said, Tasma Guru Pupatyatya Kikyasa Sriyatama Sabde Parina Nishnata Brahmani Upasana Sayam. The disciple thinks, how I can achieve the topmost auspiciousness in my life. Therefore, in order to understand that, he approaches the feet of a bona fide guru. What are the symptoms of such a bona fide spiritual master? He must be completely expert in all the shastras, especially the essence of the shastra, which is Srimad Bhagavatam. He must be equipped and be able to dispel the doubts of the disciple. He must be able to enter the heart of the disciple and empower the disciple. And he must be free from all types of bad attachments and behavior. By the mercy of such a perfected spiritual master, by this Mahakripa, one will achieve all perfection. Therefore, again, in other places discussed the symptoms of such a guru. He must be expert in the Veda, especially the Srimad Bhagavatam. He can dispel all doubts. And he himself must perform bhajan with full faith and determination. Because of performing bhajan in such a manner, he must have some realization of the Lord himself. He has the power to empower, he has the power to infuse the disciple with enthusiasm for the performance of Hari Bhajan. Such a bona fide spiritual master must be free from all type of material attachments. And he must be free from the control of the six enemies, like lust, greed, anger, envy, madness, and illusion. By the service, by serving such a spiritual master, one will achieve prema bhakti, otherwise never. Therefore, Srimad Mahaprabhu explained to Sivarupa Goswami Pad the 64 limbs of devotion, and the first five are concerned with the relationship of a spiritual master. The first is one must take shelter of such a bona fide sadhu. From him one will learn all proper types of behavior, Vaishnav Sanachar, how to worship the deity, how to mix and perform sadhu sangha. From that guru one will take initiation into Vishnu mantra and also take instructions on the process of devotion. One must also engage oneself in the service of such a guru. Therefore, before accepting mantra, the disciple should serve, should remain near the spiritual master and serve him for some time. In that time, the disciple has a full opportunity to examine the character of the guru, to see if there is any faults in the spiritual master or if the spiritual master has realized anything. In a similar vein, for that time, the guru will also examine the disciple, whether he is qualified to become a disciple, whether he has other desires except for Hari Bhajan. Thus, Sri Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur said there should be a mutual examination between the guru and the disciple. Deva Diksha Kari Bhakta Kari Atmasambhavan, Se Kari Krishna Kari Atmasam. At the time of taking initiation, the devotee completely surrenders to the spiritual master. At that time, the spiritual master bestows upon the disciple a spiritual body which is as good as Krishna, and with that spiritual body, the disciple performs the service of Radha and Krishna. Shri Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakura says how a disciple should serve the spiritual master. Just like a very chaste wife will even neglect the remembrance of her children and other such activities in order to exclusively focus on the spiritual master. In the same way, a bona fide of service of the husband, in the same way a bona fide disciple must become completely absorbed in the satisfaction of the spiritual master, forgetting everything else. By this Guru Seva, one should have complete faith, I will achieve all perfection. Even if one's absorption in Guru Seva awakens an obstacle in the performance of Shravan and Kirtan, for example, he's too busy to hear class or to perform bhajan, it doesn't matter. The service to the Guru will bestow the result of Shravan and Kirtan also. And by Guru Seva, the meaning of all the scriptures will enter the heart. A nice example in this regard is Sripad Sankaracharya. He had one disciple named Govinda, and he was always engaged in washing Sripad Sankaracharya's cloth, cooking for him, washing pots and all that other type of thing. One day Sripad Sankaracharya, when he was near in the Himalayas, he was about to give class. There were maybe 5,000 disciples there. They were very, very learned. That time Sankaracharya was simply waiting, and all the learned disciples said, "Oh Gurudev, please commence your explanation of the scriptures. Everyone is here except Govinda, but he's an idiot, he doesn't know anything anyway, so continue." But Sri Sankaracharya didn't start. Meanwhile, Govindapad was washing the cloth of Sri Sankaracharya on the other side of the Ganga, and he came running late. He sat there and began offering many amazing prayers, full of high-class Sanskrit and many deep realizations, and all the other disciples were. They couldn't understand what he was saying, so much his realizations were deep. Sripad Sankaracharya said, "This is the result of Vishrampa Guru Seva, serving the Guru with intimacy." Go Premanandi! Tomorrow is Ekadasi. Tomorrow is Ekadasi. So from here, after class and Kirtan, we'll go on Parikram. And no one should stay here, everyone should go on Parikram. Prashad is at 12 o'clock. Haribo!
Tomorrow morning, our Parikram, 5 o'clock, after Mangala Arati, so 5 o'clock started Parikram. আগামীকাল বৃন্দাবন পরিক্রমা মঙ্গলারতির পরেই আপনারা সকলে রেডি হয়ে যাবেন মঙ্গলারতির পরেই।